Good morning, YouTube. Had a few viewers ask if I could do a video on how to hook up one of these AC panel meters, and this is the PZEM-061 model, so let's do that. But first, let's take a look at a different meter. Yeah, so this is one of the P3 kilowatt meters. Many people are probably familiar with these, and I just wanted to show this as an example here. So in this meter, the power flows through the meter. You have your plug on the one side, and then you have your receptacle on the other side. And to use it, you just plug your load into the meter. You can see you've got volts, amps, watt, but that's how you use a meter like this. The reason you would want to use a meter like this is, let's say I've got my junction box here on the wall, I've got my power coming in from my circuit panel, and then I've got my load over here coming out of the box, and I want to measure how much power this load uses, and I can't plug it in to something like this because it's in the wall. So that's where you would use something like this AC panel meter. So if we bring that in, okay, back to this AC panel meter. The reason I wanted to show you that P3 kilowatt meter is that if you look at this wiring diagram here, on the surface it almost looks like the same setup. Here's the four terminals. And it looks like somehow all of this stuff here is inside of this box. But that's not the case. The way you need to look at this diagram is realize that all the wires are coming out of this side. So you almost have to flip this diagram over so that all of the wires are coming out this way, and there's two basic connections. You have here's your current transformer, or CT as they show it in the diagram, and you run one of the load conductors through here to measure the current. So that's what the current transformer does. And I would recommend hooking this up first for two reasons. One is you want to make sure you get these to the two proper terminals. In this case, these two small wires here over and to the two top terminals. If you accidentally hook the voltage up to those two terminals, you'll blow up the meter. So you want to make sure you get the current transformer hooked up first. And then the other reason it is related is that the way a current transformer works is it produces a current on the output in proportion to the current that's flowing through the middle. And because of that, a current transformer always needs to be loaded down. So the way this meter works inside is that there's a really low value resistor between these two terminals. The microcontroller inside senses the voltage across that low value resistor. And if you don't have that resistor, the voltage on these outputs can get really high to the point that it might damage the insulation. So you always want to make sure the current transformer is loaded down, and that leaves you with two other connections that go right here. And it doesn't matter which one is which. Again, what I need to do is I've got to hook these two wires, which are these two, into the incoming power. So the way this works is your power comes in from your main breaker panel, runs through the load and back out. So this is the power flow. The meter is just sensing the voltage across the two power lines. It's not actually flowing through these wires. So that's why I showed you this kilowatt meter as an example. Here the power flows through the meter. Here the power doesn't flow through the meter. So I'll just get rid of my junction box. So I've got my two terminal, maybe these are wire nuts, or I'm using these Wago lever nuts because they're really easy to work with. So I've now hooked up this part of the circuit here. I've got this wire and this wire. Okay, I think I have everything hooked up here. So I've got my power plug in here going into my quick test, and that's simulating the circuit breaker that's feeding this circuit. So here's the incoming power going to my junction box over here, and then I've got the load hooked up to these two wires, and then I've got my panel meter hooked up to these two wires. Hooked up all the wires, we can go to the breaker panel. I'll close the breaker. We now have power coming out here. I can turn on the light bulb, my load, and you can see the meter's working. We get 123 volts, and it's reading just a residual current and power there. That's not measuring anything, and in fact, you can prove that by turning on the load, and you can see nothing is happening because I'm not doing anything with the current transformer. So let's go back to the circuit panel. We open the breaker, and what I need to do, according to the wire diagram, is I've got to run one of those two wires through the current transformer. So I'll just pick one. We'll do the hot wire here. So I'll run the wire through the current transformer. And we can go back to the breaker panel, close the breaker. So you can see here I'm measuring the same voltage, and if I turn on the bulb, now I get a reading, 42 watts and 340 milliamps there. And this is a 40 watt appliance bulb, so that looks proper. Yeah, so just as a double check here, I've got my little clamp meter here. And we'll put that on the same wire there, and that's reading 0 amps. Let's see here, we're reading 340, this one's reading 344, so down to two digits, it's reading the same value there. Yeah, so hopefully that'll clear up how to wire one of these AC panel meters. And if you have any other questions on that, feel free to drop a note in the comment section below, and I'll put a link to my other videos on this panel meter up in the upper right corner. And if you haven't already done so, you can subscribe to the channel with the link in the lower right corner. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and as always, thanks for watching.